Still, the liver is about laden with 33% of it with fat. So these are early changes. And this fat inside the cell is swelling it up. And the body has got a very intriguing, very interesting phenomenon known as self-preservation. So what does the cell do in order to preserve itself? Well, the spilling effect, the overspilling of the fat into the circulation. And that, I think, is one of the major causes of insulin resistance. So overspilling in the process of trying to preserve itself or protect itself is leading to insulin resistance, and that is causing the problem. And here you see, because liver is the largest metabolic organ of the body, much bigger than any other metabolic organ, and it certainly receives a lot of insults from others also, and it performs a number of functions. And you see here that the adipose tissue, the adipocytes, which are understood to have endocrine type of functions, lipolysis over there releases these free fatty acids, which again come to the liver, and the redistribution again occurs from the liver. And let us not undermine the role of the gut. All the food which we are eating is being absorbed and sent via the portal vein or via the thoracic gut into various areas, but liver is the main receiver. So it is the liver which is causing the, which is being pushed to an extreme where all these substances, ultimately the liver is going through increased lipogenesis, decreased beta oxidation and esterification, production of triglycerides, and then, as I said, spilling into the circulation, the VLDL, the triglyceride, and the consequence is insulin resistance. So this is a very important concept, I think we probably all know, but I think it has been less emphasized. And you all know that liver plays a very important role in glucose homeostasis. It uses glucose as a fuel, which stores glucose as glycogen, and that's the biggest storage for glucose. It is the site of gluconeogenesis. If we remove the liver, a person dies because of hypoglycemia. And do not forget, all this glucose is through the portal vein, is almost all coming to the liver. What you see inside the blood is only a small proportion. So, rise in branded, post-branded plasma glucose reflects just a minor component. And the first abnormality in type 2 diabetes is postprandial hyperglycemia. What does it indicate? Well, it indicates that there is insufficient trapping of glucose inside the liver. So again, it is the liver which is causing the problem. And it is not just that, but the inflammation which we've been hearing about in earlier talks. And the liver is also both a site of inflammation and it receives inflammation from other sites. And here I have shown how the adipose tissue and the cytokines and the pro-inflammatory substances, they all arrive in the liver. The endotoxins from the gut, they also arrive in the liver. And this inflammation not only drives the inflammation inside the liver, leading to steatohepatitis, cirrhosis, etc., but also leads to all the atherogenic properties you see in the cardiac system. There is a substance called T-MAO, again produced by the liver. And this T-MAO is highly atherogenic. So it is the atherogenicity again, highly dependent again on the liver. And all the effects of insulin resistance on the muscles and other tissues are all because of the liver, the insulin resistance. I think too much of importance was given to the pancreas. Pancreas was considered the root cause of diabetes, but I'll come to that. And this is just to show that the gut is important. The bacterial translocation occurring in the gut, because diabetics have a highly permeable gut, and the organisms and the endotoxins are released into the circulation and cause inflammation not only in the liver but also at the heart, the muscles, the pancreas, adipose tissue, etc. Because there's a huge diagram, you can see simple models. You keep the wrong type of diet, high fat, high carbohydrate, insulin level goes up. Insulin level will go up, and therefore it will push the fat inside the liver, and the fatty liver develops. But there is this fatty liver, which gives rise to, which overspilling of the triglycerides, insulin resistance, and causing higher insulin, and it goes into a circle, self-perpetuating. But I would like to point another aspect, which is the fructose. And I think this is something.
In case of the diet, then again, the secretary would like to read the annual report of the association. As you all know, Uttar Pradesh Diabetes Association is a registered body of doctors working in the field of diabetes across Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand. It all started with a small spark 17 years ago and has now assumed a full-fledged conglomeration of scientific endeavor. At present, it has more than 1,350 members. The association was established in 2002 with the aim of organizing educational programs in the field of diabetes for its members. It also holds regional and state level meetings. It encourages research in the field of diabetes by instituting a number of awards and fellowships for distinguished work in both academic and social fields. The year 2017-18 saw the association performing a number of activities to achieve its aims. The 16th annual conference of the UPDACON Association was held on 13, 14 and 15th of October 2017 at Dr. Krishna Palace, Faisalabad, UP, with Dr. Viren Singh as its organizing secretary. The UPDACON 17 was allotted 8 credit hours by the NCI. 65 faculty members, 195 delegates, 30 oral post representations, and more than 100 pharma personnel attended the conference. More than 30 delegates participated in the oral and poster presentation. On 14th October, the conference was inaugurated by Sri Lalu Singh, Honorary Member of Parliament of Faisalabad, and Dr. Mangesh Srivastava, Honorary Secretary KPI, was the guest of honor. The convocation ceremony was presided by Professor Manoj Dixit, Honorary Vice Chancellor of Aravind Abad University, Faisalabad. And the fellowship oration was delivered by Dr. Rajiv Chawla, Secretary, National RSGA. The new UPDA celebrated the World Diabetes Day throughout UP and a lot of activities. Dr. N.K. Soni, President of UPDA, gave a diabetes awareness lecture to Yashoda Hospital, Ghaziabad, for public as well as patients of the hospital. In Lucknow, a walkathon was organized at the Bankers Institute of Rural Development, Birth Complex, to celebrate the World Diabetes Day. This was followed by a public education program attended by large audience comprising the officer and their families. This program was conducted by Dr. Sanjay Arora, Treasurer of UPDA, along with Dr. Anuj Maheshwari and myself. The UPDA further organized a public education program in IMA Bhavan for patients in Lucknow. It was conducted by my friend Dr. Sunil Gupta and Dr. Sanjay Arora. Dr. Nadeesh Fatima, the Joint Secretary, and Professor Era Medical College, Lucknow, organized a nurses education program and insulin workshop at a college under the banner of UPDA. Dr. Kailash Chawla, nominated Joint Secretary to the Diabetes Detection Camp in Ghaziabad, where 780 persons were tested for blood sugar, and among them 22 new patients were detected.